Hello and welcome to Anjali's Bake Affair.
So today we will make a chocolate cake. This is going to be eggless and it's going to be baked not in an oven but in your good old cooker. Believe me.
What you need for this cake is flour, cocoa powder, baking powder, baking soda, sugar, buttermilk, oil and vanilla.
Just a few points to keep in mind. The first thing is that the size of your cooker should be substantially larger than the size of the baking tin that you are going to use inside the cooker. Now, this cooker is going to act like our oven. Yes, we are going to transform it into the oven. You do not need the pressure on top. You do not need the ring inside the lid. Take these things away. On heat and pour in a big cup full of salt in it. My salt may look a little dark and discolored to you. That's because I reuse this in baking. So put in the salt, level it up, and then place some metal ring or plate to make the whole thing such that your baking tin stays well balanced on it while the cake gets baked. Cover it up and now leave it on low heat to preheat while we start on the batter.
And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Now the batter for this eggless chocolate cooker cake is fairly simple. Just take a big bowl and sift in the flour, the cocoa powder, baking powder and baking soda into the bowl. Once that's done, make a little space, a well kind of place in the middle, and that's where the other ingredients go in. So in goes the buttermilk, the oil, the powdered sugar and the vanilla bean paste. Mix everything up nice and well till you get a smooth, shiny, liquid batter. Now take a baking tin, grease it, line it, and pour this beautiful batter into it. And by now, our cooker must already be ready and waiting for the cake. It must be preheated. Take out the lid and now be very careful from this point onwards because this cooker, every part of it that's metal is super hot. You do not want to burn yourself. Take in your baking tin with the cake batter very carefully and put it inside in the center.
And there should be enough space all around the baking tin for air to move around and make sure that the baking is consistent.
Cover it with the lid, leave it on low to medium heat and then let it bake for about 30 minutes. You can check after 30 minutes to see if it's done. So you need to be very careful, take a cloth, use gloves, whatever safety measures you have around. This one looks very well done. There is no liquid batter sticking to my skewer. Now time to let it cool down completely inside the cooker. After that, we'll take it out and frost it and cut it. So once it's cooled down, take it out of the cooker and run a knife all around the cake just to make sure that it's not stuck anywhere. Invert the tin over a plate or platter or cake stand. Out it comes, looking lovely. You can just enjoy it as it is or you can frost it I used my chocolate cream frosting to frost the cake. The recipe for this chocolate cream frosting is there on my website anjulisbakeaffair.com and on my channel as well. The links to which are there down in the description box. You can check it out. Now let's get a slice of this. Wow, dark and moist. So go ahead, make this cake, tell me how it turned out. So till next time, bye-bye and enjoy.